Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. What you saw is not ritualistic. We don't always want to keep the mats together, but somehow the every day we go through has its own issues and its own things we have to deal with. It's just something we have to deal with and something that is very annoying, so I have to stand over here. What you saw today was lots of different styles, so a lot of different techniques of Aikido. Basically, you can be defined into Kihonwaza, basic technique, Jiwaza, which means free movement, Oyowaza, advanced techniques, or also ratio of multiple attackers. I was told by someone, and I'm not mentioning Christian's name, that over the last couple of years I've been talking too much, so he said, don't talk too much, do a bit more Aikido, I'll try and do that. In Kamae, like this, everything in Yoshinai is part of the Kamae and ends with Kamae. It's the single most important thing. So, from here, we learn that someone pulls. So, I hold my posture. If he pushes, I hold my posture. Once he pulls or pushes, and I don't move, then I can use his energy. If as he pushes, I go back, I can't use his energy. So, basic techniques teach us to do this. Then we learn how to move with the basic techniques, using the basic techniques in the basic format. We learn to do techniques like that. And from there, we also learn self-defense. All in all, Aikido is a it's a holistic martial art in that it teaches you about yourself, it teaches you how to defend yourself, and most of all, it teaches you to be a better person. Not a better Joe Tambu, but a better whoever you are. Sorry, Christine, where are you? I had to read all the profile someone wrote for me from a magazine lately, and they had all listed all my accomplishments. And I glazed over them and I thought, none of this means anything. For me, the biggest accomplishment, especially for those of you who know me, is the fact that Dantis was on that. That is the biggest single accomplishment I think. The ranks, the titles, they gave me nothing. The fact that I've done it, and for someone I mean, gets bored very easily. But I maintain to do it, manage to do it for so long and keep doing it without stopping, and that's my biggest accomplishment. And I think for all of us here, we have to change the way we think. When we come to the dojo, we don't come to learn, we come to do. Aikido is a culture, it's a martial art. If you think about learning, at some point you're going to stop. You're going to defend yourself, at some point you'll stop. If you think about it being a part of your life, I'm going to do something, then you will continue to do it. And it starts to get more enjoyable. So the work what you saw today with the Kihonwaza, that's us preparing people with the basics. And then they get to express themselves in the Jiwaza competition, where the pairs get to figure out their own routines, they work on that tirelessly, effortlessly, and they come up with a very good product. And that's them expressing the idea. So I'm trying to do that now.
Thank you.
comes to learn a martial art or to learn anything, we put ourselves at a disadvantage. And when we have to put ourselves at a disadvantage, we have to use our brains a little more. So it's like carrying the weights down behind your leg, but at a disadvantage, when you go into a work habit, your mind is going to work out. Look like this. has to do that, but he doesn't have to do like that. I think after many years, I understand that being martial is not an action, it's a way of being. How you conduct yourself, how you look, how you walk, how you talk. And in anything, that's what we want to teach your kids. It's about being passionate about what you do, and it's about being strong in what you do. I weigh about 58 kilos on a good day. So if I rely on strength or power, I'd never get anywhere. Teaching places in Eastern Europe where 6-year-old kids are my size. And it's really quite hard sometimes. But if I try and tell them what to do, it's not going to happen. I have to first prove that I can do it. And then they start to believe it, and then they start to do it. Aikido is a lot about believing too. And I think over the last 2 years, the most important thing in Aikido for me has been about projecting your power and focusing your power. So if I was to do this, it doesn't work. I need them in my center and in my corner, I will pull it forward. Same thing like this.
What?
So if I have someone like this, and I can't move them, I have to bring them to my center. And the feeling here is not to actually move them. Me fighting it. But if I focus, for instance, an imaginary spot up there, and if I touch the spot, then it becomes easy. And once I take it out, I can have my own power. I have to look after my partner. And in turn, if I can do that to them and still exercise my art, then they can do it to me. I like to think of us and the daughter as a community, not as a team. counted here. A lot of people have their children here. And it's very much community. And you are very much an important part of it. A lot of people who don't train still come in and support us at UC. But it's really good to be able to do this once a year. And believe you me, it's the single most stressful day of my life. I get up and do demonstrations overseas in front of 3,000 people. I get up in front of the royalty, it's not a problem. Today, it's the most stressful day. And often, we ask ourselves why we do this, why we do this. But every year, after the demonstration, I see the improvement of the students and say, yeah, that's what it is. Thank you very much.